Hey everyone, welcome to part two of my Klondike tutorial. I've already made a project called CGK, which stands for Console Game Klondike, and I've already made a file in this project called types.h and added some boilerplate code. So basically, we're just going to be defining all our types that we're going to use for our program in this file. Please note that my code is not going to be the best, but I'm going to try to make my code clear and concise as possible since I am still quite a beginner at C++. And what we're going to do is I'm going to just copy code over from my notes just to speed it up, since I don't think you guys want to sit here all day looking at me type everything out. So I'm going to start off with some basic definitions, and this is just some macros that we're going to be using for the duration of our program. So first, I'm going to define our number of decks as 1, since I've already explained in the last video we're only going to be using the settings, or sorry, the rules we're going to be using for this program. We're only going to be using 1 deck of cards, and we're only going to have 7 different piles. And I'm also going to define our number of suits and our cards in the suit as 4 and 13. Next, I'm going to do some static constant expressions. So this is just some basic math that we're basically telling the compiler that, hey, this variable is not going to be changing for the duration of our program, and it's going to be able to be calculated at runtime. So as soon as we compile the program, they should already have know what the value of this variable is. And in this case, it's going to be 52, since we know that we have 13 cards in a suit and we have 4 suits. And basically, I could just type out 52 over here, but I just want to make it clear for you guys where this number is coming from. So next, I'm going to talk about our stock size. So our stock size is basically going to be calculating how many cards do we have in the stock. And we're basically assuming that our cards in each pile is increasing. So the pile 1 has 1 card, pile 2 has 2 cards, and we have this very basic algebra formula to calculate how many cards we're going to have total in all piles. And we're just going to subtract our number of all our cards from that, since the rest are going to be in our stock. And finally, we want something to track how many cards could we have at most in each pile. Since we're going to be storing the cards in each pile as an array, we want this to be defined as the maximum size of that array. And here, basically, we're just taking the number of cards that could be in a pile at most, which is 7, since we start off with 7 cards, and we're adding 13 to that, which is our number of cards in a suit. So in theory, the maximum number of cards that could be in a pile is 20. So this is just what we're going to be using for the duration of our tutorial. And lastly, I'm going to leave you guys off with our first data structure slash data type, which is our cards. And this is basically just to define what each card is. So for example, CA would stand for Ace of Clubs, S7 would stand for 7 of Spades, and so on. And this is just going to make it easier for us to extract information about each card, such as its rank and suit. As we go forward, which is going to be useful when we're determining if the move is valid or not. So thank you guys for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below, and I'll see you guys in the next part.